Hello and welcome to Nirmal Bang, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Hiral Daria. We have with us Riya Singh, technical analyst, currencies joining in. Riya, welcome to the show. Riya, my first question coming to you is, clearly there is weakness with regards to where the Indian rupee goes. We have been awaiting the FOMC meeting outcome, as well as we have the budget ahead of us as well. What's your view?
Currently there has been a decline into the Indian rupee strength. We were waiting quite a bit for this because it was, getting consolidated within the range of 74.75 and 74.28 and so on. The breakout has come today, but the sustainability of the same is a question because obviously there is a FOMC meet that is coming up, which is signaling a tightening of the monetary policy there, which could definitely trigger some, after effects of the dollar getting strong. But apart from that, I think there could be some relaxation that will come from RBI itself. Because, during these pandemic years, RBI has accumulated a lot of forex in order to tackle any emergency situation that could arise in order to, meet the Exim balance and so on. So I think going forward, it will definitely be, sidelined or, into a consolidated range itself, because all the negative factors that is currently there, the stronger dollar and, of course, the crude oil again gaining traction. The RBI actions of getting some of those the forex levels down, and secondly, of course, the VRR's auction that it has been doing will offset all the negative impact. So I think it could definitely hover around the area of 75 to on a broader perspective, for the coming year also, you can definitely see it hovering around 7550 to 7390 range on a longer, on a yearly base prospectus. But other than that, I think until there is some confirmation, the Fed releases a statement, and then the what guidelines will the FM present into the budget will help in giving the Indian rupee some guidelines. So overall, I'm not seeing a major spike in either of the sides. 75.15 maximum on the higher side, but I think from there it will again move towards 74.50 and 74.28 range. So not much of momentum there.
Right. Moving on, if you see in terms of the dollar index, there is some bit of a risk on sentiment that we are seeing, and there is strength and there is optimism that's coming in on the dollar index, on the right. Dollar. How do you see it from here on?
I think the inflation has been quite, persistent, and I think it is taking a longer shelf life than that was anticipated by the Fed altogether. So there is a lot of, expectation that the Fed might go for a rate hike. But there is also fear that if the rate hikes happens too soon, it will dampen the consumer sentiment and consumer spending altogether. So there is a lot of, factors that the Fed has to tackle with in its upcoming FOMC. Then there is also geopolitical tension that is going on between the Russia and Ukraine, which is, which is leading the US to put around 8,500 troops there as a, NATO forces in the Eastern Europe. So there is a geopolitical tension that is arising right now into the world, which is again, fueling the risk on sentiment. So this will again aid into the, get the dollar stronger. So going forward, I think dollar will remain on a stronger hold. At least until FOMC meet and what will come out of this, the Russia-Ukraine tension that is going on. So, caution on that side.
Right. What would your view be with regards to where the pound is concerned? Yeah, because clearly, if you see in terms of the pound as well, it seems pretty choppy lately.
Yes, I think with the dollar remaining on a stronger hold and Bank of England turning hawkish, there's a lot of zigzag momentum that is going on into the pound. Now, of course, the major reason why the Bank of England went for a rate cut was because of the inflation, to tackle the inflation situation. But if you look at the current statements that have been by the policy makers and so on, so even they are anticipating that UK inflation will stay longer than anticipated. And I think if it does, and there is any further rate cuts that will come, that it could tighten the monetary policy. So right now the situation is, if the inflation goes out of hand, what the central bank can do is cut the rates. But then they don't have they the question arises that they are not doing it very aggressively, because even if you look at the UK economy altogether, they are still into the economic recovery phase from the pandemic. They have not just they are still recovering. And if the monetary tightening happens too soon, it will tamper the momentum altogether. So this is the reason why there is so mismatched views that is there into the pound altogether, and we are seeing the same indecisiveness into the momentum itself. So going forward, I think it will definitely remain either on the weaker side or into a sideways consolidated range. No major upside for now on the pound perspective.
Right. So taking this view into consideration, what are the strategies that you would recommend?
The strategies that one can go forward is going short into the GBP INR below the level of 100.68 for a target of 100.50, 100.42. Keep a strict SL at 100.85. You can also go short into the Euro INR below the level of 84.40. For the target of 84.25, 84.10, with the strict SL at 84.50. JPY INR is trading on the higher side, but I think it could come down for a short recovery in the strength that it has seen today. So you can go short into the JPY INR below the level of 65.48. For a target of 65.27, keep a strict SL at 65.55.
All right, so these are a few of the strategies that one should be looking at as well. Thank you, Ria. Thank you, participants, for joining in.
Thank you, Yil.
Subscribe to our YouTube channel for in-depth interviews of India Inc. and press the bell icon so that you do not miss our updates.